Hello, everyone. Meteorologist Mike Haddad here in the Storm Watch 9 Weather Center. Quite a few changes just over the last, say, 24 hours. We went from seasonably mild yesterday to much cooler today. And now that a warm front is moving on through, winds are about to kick around to the south, southwest, as opposed to the southeast, like we had today, keeping it cool and raw. And that shift, just by 30, 40 degrees in the wind, will drive our temperatures at least into the 60s and lower 70s. In many spots tomorrow. Now, it is much cooler to the west, so we will not be under this envelope of very warm air for that long, probably tomorrow. And then over the weekend, it stays on the muggy side, but temperatures come down just a little bit as rain chances increase Friday night and Saturday. For the here and now, though, temperatures kind of hold where they are a good part of the evening. And then overnight tonight, they could actually rise a little bit. You'll head out to 40s north, 50s on average in southern parts of the state. Showers move through up until about midnight, 1, 2 a.m. in spots, but not everywhere. And then tomorrow, clouds break, some partial sun. And look at our temperatures, low to mid-60s north, low 70s south. And even along the coastline, we should make a run at least into the 60s before it cools late in the day. Showers and maybe even a thunderstorm develop later Friday night and on and off into Saturday and Saturday evening. There could be a few downpours here or there. Again, that chance of a thunderstorm, and because of the rain about to move in and a rapid snow melt where there's still quite a snow cover in the North Country, a flooding concern begins Saturday morning and runs right through Sunday. So if you live along area rivers and streams from the North Country all the way into Merrimack County and in western parts of the state, keep a close eye on the river levels between Saturday morning and Sunday night.